huge scare for the humanity in this world was the situation of HIV and AIDS, human immunodeficiency virus, as it's called HIV, was quite something that everybody was afraid of, whether you are a lay citizen or a medical or a paramedical person, because how it transmits and how to deal with it was a huge topic for discussion with the frights that it brought in. The mother-to-child transmission of HIV. Well, the blood-borne HIV or the virus can get into the system of the child through the blood supply which the mother provides through her placenta. So what is the best way to avoid it? Firstly, every potential pre-pregnancy care should include an HIV test, because if she's already HIV positive, there are certain things that we need to do. HIV is a virus, as I have told you, and the viral load, how much of the virus is multiplying in the mother's body? If it's thousands of copies, then we need to do something to cut that multiplication, to give her what we call, if HIV is a virus, we give her an antiviral treatment. Hello everyone, this is Dr. Hema Divakar, a senior OBGYN consultant at the Divakars Specialty Hospital, J.P Nagar, Bengaluru. You will agree with me that before we had the scare of COVID, another huge scare for the humanity in this world was the situation of HIV and AIDS, human immunodeficiency virus, as it's called HIV, was quite something that everybody was afraid of, whether you are a lay citizen or a medical or a paramedical person, because how it transmits and how to deal with it was a huge topic for discussion with the frights that it brought in. The mother-to-child transmission of HIV. Well, the blood-borne HIV or the virus can get into the system of the child through the blood supply which the mother provides through her placenta. So what is the best way to avoid it? Firstly, every potential pre-pregnancy care should include an HIV test, because if she's already HIV positive, there are certain things that we need to do. At least in early pregnancy, we definitely do the HIV test, which is a blood test for all the early pregnancy cases. And if it is positive, potentially, yes, we know it can be transmitted not only in pregnancy, but also in delivery. If it's a vaginal delivery, it can also be transmitted through the breast milk and handling of the baby even post-delivery. So there are a lot of potential scope to transmit the HIV into the child. What will happen if the HIV infection transmits to the child? One of the most common things is the baby will be born with the HIV positive infection, and it's a great lifetime trauma to deal with, or it may just miscarry or abort because of the HIV per se in the early or middle of pregnancy. There can be a lot of malformations in the major organs of the baby. So all in all, it is best to prevent the HIV transmission from the mother to the baby, and inclusive of issues such as low birth babies, premature deliveries, etc. It brings in, as you can imagine, a host of problems if the mother is HIV positive and you don't take care to limit the transmission to the baby. So what do we do for those whom we detect HIV positive? HIV is a virus, as I have told you. And the viral load, how much of the virus is multiplying in the mother's body? If it's thousands of copies, then we need to do something to cut that multiplication, to give her what we call, if HIV is a virus, we give her an antiviral treatment. ART is an antiretroviral, because the family of this virus is like a retro songs, retro movies, you would have heard this, a retrovirus. So the ART treatment is antiretroviral treatment, which is by way of medication. There are some standard protocols for this. So if you start treating the mother even before the pregnancy, if the situation is already known to you, or during the early part of the pregnancy where you have detected her to be HIV positive, the whole load of viral duplication or multiplication can be avoided by giving the antiretroviral medication. And the CD4 count is an indirect indicator of how well the mother is doing. And if you minimize the duplication of the viruses, if you decrease the viral load, if the CD4 counts are well within the limits that you accept, then there is every chance that this infection will not transmit from the mother to the baby. And that is so very important to do. And this therapy continues not only throughout pregnancy, but also during breastfeeding. She's allowed to breastfeed when she's on this therapy, but exclusive breastfeeding for 6 months is recommended, because if you mix up the breastfeeding and the formula feed, then there is more chance of intestinal infection for the baby. And if there are cuts in the baby's intestine, the HIV virus can go through that and then affect the baby. So either you give a total formula feed, which is done in most of the Western countries, or you give a total exclusive 6 months of breastfeeding. That's the right thing to do. So various ways where you can prevent the transmission. Be aware that if you do not recognize this, your babies can get into trouble. And also, more importantly, beware that there are huge advances in the HIV treatment, and even the mode of delivery, which typically preferred is the cesarean section, because the transmission at the time of delivery can be minimized by a C-section. But if your viral load is really low, CD4 counts are really in the good range, vaginal delivery can be allowed, and it will not enhance the chances of the baby contacting with the HIV infection. So there is a lot of advances. You need to go not only to an OBGYN, but she will cross-check with the HIV specialist, because it's a whole new branch by itself. And anyways, the right information and the right kind of management will sail you through this crisis of producing a healthy baby on time. No matter, even if it is by an operative delivery, the outcome is still expected to be as nearly normal, with less than 1% chances of the baby being impacted with your HIV status. So stay positive, even though you're HIV positive.